So having marked all the roundness of the neckline and trimmed away the excess on the outer side, it's a bit annoying because it keeps rolling back up, and I don't really want to cut into this because it's a shame to just waste the inside. I'm going to cut on the inside of this as well. So what we've basically done is worked on the same template to cut around a neckline, just slightly curved it wherever we sort of felt that the roundness was of a circle was coming. Now it's it's actually quite difficult to tell, I'm on the wrong place. It's probably more of an oval than a complete round, because a complete round is also not something that, if you look at the shape of your unless you wear very, very wide necklines, it's quite difficult to wear off anything like this that's on a complete round of, say, 7 inches and 7 inches, or 8 inches and 8 inches. Generally, the very wide necklines are cut absolutely round, but they are quite revealing. And the other thing with that type of neckline is you need to have your camise very, very tightly fitted around this area. So if the neckline is fairly wide, then you would need to have your camise very tightly pulled and fitted around this area so that it doesn't gap, because a wide neckline, and if the camise is quite loose from these areas, what will happen is the dress will gap, and when you bend down, it sort of you can see your cleavage quite a fair way down. So I mean, obviously we all have different standards and we all have different tastes on how the kind of stuff that we wear. Some of our families and men mind us wearing wide necklines. Some of us feel quite conscious of the necklines, even ourselves, if they're too wide. And then some of us are not too bothered and will basically, you know, it's generally the men who really, really mind. We should be conscious of it ourselves, obviously, because it's in our own modesty and in our own, you know, thing that we keep a fairly low profile sort of image. Now the other one that I'm going to cut is a slightly angled down neckline, similar to the one that the doll has got on. I'm going to use the same template and I'm going to mark it out on the same template. If you just mark out the basic shape on the interfacing in the same shape, the same markings on the template, then what you need to do is first of all mark the outside out and then work inwards. So if you've marked that out at an angle, then you need to work inwards and measure 1 inch above, say like here, and then 1 inch in to meet that, and then you're curving that out. So that shape although from the top it's we're working on the same, I'm just going to take the excess buckram interfacing away from this because it's actually quite annoying. Now that's the shape. Then what you need to do is you need to cut into this, and for this type of neckline what you will need to do is measure the depth that you want from here and then lessen it from the top. So if you wanted the depth of this, the fall of the neckline, measure it from your between the bone, how long you want the point and where you want it to end. So say for instance if we take the mannequin and if we measure it on her, if we were going by that length, then we would mark it off from where my point of my finger is, leaving enough allowance for our seaming, and just trim away the excess. So always leave it in excess, because if you use the neckline for someone who's slightly taller or less, you know, requires the neckline a little bit deeper, you can always trim this away. Even when you attach the fabric, you can trim this away. So it's always to have good to have the length on this sort of fairly long. Just remember when attaching this with the actual garment that you're careful on where you're attaching it, because if you attach it too low, that's when problems arise and your neckline will come out deep, even though there are solutions to that. I mean, if you had, you could do a fancy trimming inside the neckline to actually lessen it. It's something that I will teach you. I would probably go with this neckline. I would probably go with this neckline on the on the neck that I'm doing at the moment. So that's your couple of descriptions of necklines. I mean, what we've done is we've done a shaped one. We've done this shape, the stand up collar one, we've done a round one, we've done a square one. The shapes are entirely up to you. I will come back to the necklines in some future lessons where I will teach you how to do some more more stylish and more some different forms and different cuttings. So for the moment, I think it's enough to get you started onto basic necklines and to get into the practice of doing fairly basic necklines. Now, there was one other one that I was actually going to show you. This is all wastage, and that is actually my... Now, there was one that I was going to show you before I actually went and cut my template, and this was a round neckline that I was going to do. So it's actually in the form of the square, but then I'm going to just round it off. Now, what I'd done was I had done this fairly wide because I wanted to interline this with another, I'll do this again on the other side because it's just a little bit right. I'm going to do the neckline fairly wide because I want to interline this. And I'll show you what I mean by interlining it. I've left about half an inch. It's going to be about half an inch wider than a general neckline. I'm just going to mark it out sort of on the square. Then I'm just going to round this off. Always pin the two pieces into place, because otherwise what happens is the pieces tend to get move out of place. I'm just a little bit conscious that I don't want to go over the 10-minute limit. Now this is a round shape that we're cutting out. I'm going to trim away over here, and then this round I'm going to attach another sort of a collar sort of type of neckline inside of this. And what I'm going to do with for that is I'm going to place the neckline inside this. I'm just going to mark it out and measuring around. I'm taking this much excess away, so I'm using the same interfacing. So this is like a galette inside a round neck in a contrasting color. And the way this would fold is, this is our round neckline and this is our galette neckline. And what we would do is attach this on the inside in a contrasting color to sort of like form like a two-in-one neckline. So basically what would happen is, the only thing to bear in mind when you cut that neckline is make sure to cut the inside one fairly wide so that it fits. Cut this one fairly wide, but then cut this one on the outskirts fairly wide so that that fits inside of the neckline like this. And this is like a collar type of a neckline where you have one sort of